Are you wondering how to fix the dead outlet? You are at the right place. Today I will show you step by step how to use a multimeter to test an outlet. The multimeter is great for testing an outlet. The whole process is simple. You need to follow a few simple instructions that I have described in detail. The most important thing is safety. With current, you have to be careful. The voltage of 120 V can hurt you if you touch the power wire. My honest recommendation is to use insulated gloves. It will protect you, even if you accidentally touch the live wire. Also, inspect the correctness of your multimeter. If you notice that it has physical damage or loses connection, it would be best to buy a new multimeter. To be safe and secure. If you want to run, you have to know how to walk. Before connecting a multimeter, you need to understand how the outlet works. The socket is very simple. It has three holes. The first hole or left hole is neutral. The second hole is hot, located on the right side. And the third hole is the ground. You need to adjust the range correctly for measuring. It often happens to beginners that the selector switch stays on the DC voltage and burns the multimeter components. It's also important to put it on a higher value to avoid an overload error. Use the auto range function if you have it on your multimeter. If your multimeter does not have the necessary functions to test the outlet, in the description, you can find the best multimeters for you. Your multimeter usually comes with two probes. One's red and one's black. Connect the black probe to the COM entrance. The red probe is going in the V's entrance voltage. At the socket, there is a red circle that will help you find the entry easier. Make sure it's well connected. First, connect the probes with neutral and hot holes. It doesn't matter in what order you insert because the ACE voltage has no polarity. The number you see on the screen is ACE voltage. The voltage should be between 110 V and 130 volts. Everything below and above shows that your socket is not working correctly. Now connect the probes to the hot and ground. The result you need to get is the same as with neutral and hot. This means that the multimeter should show between 110 and 130 volts. Also, less and more voltage than that is a sign that the ground is incorrect. In the last test, you should connect the probes with neutral and ground holes. The result of this measurement should always be zero. If the multimeter shows a voltage higher than zero, it means that the hot wire is touching one of these two wires, and it would be best if you fix that right away. The multimeter is good for this testing outlet. Still, it is often difficult for beginners to use because they have to pay attention to many things, such as adjusting the range, properly connecting the probes, and other things. It is recommended for all inexperienced people to use tools that are designed for quick and easy outlet testing. This tool is called an outlet tester. You can find this tool in the description. Now I will show you how to test outlets for Europe. The process is the same for other types of outlets. In the description, you can find all tools.